a glass half full or half empty kind of person. I'm gonna go ahead and guess half full, especially if you're a chimp. Hey everyone, Julia here for DNews. Have you ever scrolled through a streaming website searching for the perfect movie and just can't choose? Do you kinda just give up? You're not alone. Too many options seems overwhelming to us. A study published in the Journal of Personality and Social Psychology over 10 years ago put this idea to the test. You might know it as the famous paradox of choice study. Researchers set up two situations, one in which people chose from 6 varieties of jam and the other from 24 varieties. The larger display got more attention, but only a tenth of the amount of purchases. The researchers conclude that too many options turned off the shoppers. The cost of making a decision grows with each new option. With more choice comes more anxiety and regret. What if you make the wrong choice? And they just simply felt too overwhelmed. So in a world full of too many choices, how do retailers get you to choose their option? Well, manipulation. I mean marketing. By framing one option that's relatively equal to all the others in a positive light, we're more likely to just go with it, maybe just to make the anxiety stop. Research shows that presenting the same information in a positive frame yields a better result than negatively framing it. And it seems there's not much you can do about your susceptibility to it. It might be in your DNA. All things being equal, people prefer a hopeful spin. We like to think of our glasses as half full. This is called framing. Humans above and beyond choose positive framing. They will choose the 75% lean steak rather than the 25% fat one, even though they're exactly the same. Researchers used to think that this was because of human culture or something to do with our society, but as it turns out, our nearest primate relatives, chimpanzees and bonobos, like to look on the bright side too. Researchers framed food options for both of our nearest relatives. To frame in chimp language, they gave them the option to choose a handful of nuts or fruit. In one trial, the researchers framed the fruit option positively by showing a smaller handful, but by sometimes giving it an extra piece. In another trial, the fruit was framed negatively. Sometimes they were shown a larger handful, but then actually received a little less. The chimps had a preference for the option framed as a prize rather than an option framed as a penalty, even when both options were pretty much equal. The researchers say this suggests that a positive framing bias has more basis in our DNA than in our culture. So with that in mind, we've got two video options down here for you to watch. This one's okay, but you're gonna be blown away by this one. You should click it, go on, click it. While you're at it, hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back for more DNews every day of the week.